As of June 29th of 2025, there are currently 47 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet, a total which is the same number as were erupting last week, albeit with two changes. One of these complexes is Italy's famed Mount Stromboli, which since it has been near continuously erupting for the last 5,000 years, has been nicknamed the Lighthouse of the Mediterranean. This is owed largely to the fact that its persistent orange glow is often visible from a fair distance. And now, here are this week's top volcano-related news stories. In Costa Rica, the Rincon de la Vieja volcano erupted anew, but the eruption it produced was absurdly small yet still explosive. Meanwhile, in Indonesia, a swarm of low-frequency earthquakes is ongoing at Java's Tangkuban Parahu volcano, suggesting the movement of magma or gases below ground. And, in what is this week's top story, the new eruption of Japan's Kirishima volcano has continued to intensify, producing plumes of ash that have reached up to altitudes of 3,048 meters or 10,000 feet. This eruption began at 4:20 p.m. local time on June 22nd, specifically at the volcano's most active vent since 1924, known as Shinmo Dake, outlined here. This initial eruption was explosive, albeit fairly minor, sending up a sustained 800-meter-high plume that drifted to the east-northeast. Despite the low intensity of that activity, since all of the ash was confined to a very small region, it caused up to several millimeters thick of material to fall on homes, cars, and roads. This initial eruption lasted for at least 8 hours, representing a low NVEI-1 explosive eruption. While no lava bombs were ejected, this eruption was not phreatic but rather phreatomagmatic, just with a very negligible magmatic component. As a result, the alert level of Kirishima's Shinmo Dake event was raised from 2 to 3, and people were told to be vigilant within 3 kilometers in all directions of Shinmo Dake. Specifically, because unexpected pyroclastic flows could reach within a 2-kilometer radius and thrown blocks of material could technically reach up to 3 kilometers away. Later in the week, Shinmo Dake erupted again on the 26th and then multiple times each on the 27th and 28th. The latest eruption generated a 10,000-foot-high eruption plume, but there are still no fresh lava bombs despite the magmatic nature of the still ongoing activity. What makes this eruption all the more interesting is that it is technically a fissure eruption originating from two closely spaced 60-meter-long fissures which are erupting along their entire length. Whether this will progress to actual lava effusion is unknown, but if that does occur, the chance of the eruption becoming even more explosive and thus more hazardous will notably increase. Meanwhile, in Indonesia, the Tangkuban Parahu volcano has been experiencing a swarm of low-frequency earthquakes since June 1st. While these did decrease for a time, they remained elevated and then began to increase in number once again, with more than 100 such events occurring on certain days. For reference, per a direct quote from the U.S. Geological Survey, long period LP or low frequency LF earthquakes are caused by cracks resonating as magma and gases move towards the surface. They are often seen prior to volcanic eruptions, but their occurrence is also part of the normal background seismicity at some volcanoes, and their occurrence does not necessarily indicate that an eruption is imminent. While no uplift or notable changes in surface gas emissions have been observed, clearly either magma or gases are moving underneath this volcano. At what depth this is occurring at is unclear, but for now, Parahu's alert level is still green. And, in Costa Rica, the acidic crater lake-filled volcano of Rincon de la Vieja erupted for its first time in 3 weeks on June 26th. The eruption in question occurred at 5:20 p.m. local time, only lasting for a few seconds and generating a 100-meter-high ash plume via a purely phreatic eruption. This eruption was so small that I am not even sure we could even classify it on the Volcanic Explosivity Index as a 1, since it fits the description of a 0. This might seem strange, but the very tiniest of explosive eruptions still can be assigned a rating of a 0 if they eject less than 10,000 cubic meters of tephra, which this eruption at Rincon de la Vieja seems to have done. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on June 28th of 2025. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube for supporting my work.